Imagine, just for a moment, that within each of us lies a hidden set of knowledge, secrets of the universe we have never been taught, but somehow all inherently understand. Except that this is not an imagination, it's the concept of a philosophical doctrine known as innatism. Innatism, at its core, suggests that the human mind is not a blank slate at Earth being filled with knowledge through a sensory experience like the empiricism view would advocate, but rather, the mind comes with a pre-installed set of knowledge. Innatism proposes that we're born with more than just the capacity for knowledge. We are born with the knowledge itself. Unlike empiricism, which posits that the experience writes the script of our knowledge, innatism suggests we're born with a script already in hand. Now, this isn't about detailed facts like the names of capitals or historical dates, but about the more fundamental understandings. The innate concepts of mathematics, the rapid grasp of languages, or the inherent sense of morality. Imagine realizing that the ability to distinguish right from wrong, or the capacity to recognize patterns and logical sequences, isn't something you've learned piece by piece your whole life, but rather, something that has been with you, silently guiding you since your very first breath. This perspective shifts the field of learning and education. If certain knowledge is innate, education becomes not so much about acquiring new information, but about cultivating an environment where this pre-existed knowledge can come to the forefront, be recognized, and be applied. Philosophers have wondered about these questions for centuries, weaving a rich tapestry of theories and arguments that span the entirety of human thought. The concept of innatism has captivated minds from the ancient philosophers to modern-day thinkers. Plato, one of the earliest advocates of this theory, envisioned a realm of perfect forms, where the soul, even before being born on Earth, is acquainted with all the truths to life. This recollection theory suggests that learning is merely the soul's journey of remembering what it already knows, or what it has already learned in the past, long before birth. Centuries later, René Descartes further developed innatism, arguing that certain ideas, especially those fundamental to reasoning and God's existence, are innate. These ideas, he believed, are the foundations upon which all other knowledge is built, clear and distinct markers in the landscape of the mind. Noam Chomsky would also introduce the concept of a universal grammar, an innate structure of language that underlies all human speech. Chomsky's theory suggests that the only explanation for children having the ability to acquire knowledge so quickly must be the presence of pre-wired knowledge in the soul and brain. Innatism encourages us to explore the knowledge buried in our minds, to uncover the innate ideas that reside within. But what are these ideas? Well, they can range from basic logical principles like the concept of cause and effect, to moral intuitions about right and wrong, and even to the universal structures of language that bind humanity. These very ideas, untouched by the external world, form what we perceive as our understanding of everything. In a world where innatism holds, the process of learning transforms from mere accumulation of information to the awakening of the truths that are already within us. It posits that the education is not just the transmission of knowledge from the external world by ways such as reading, but a journey of uncovering the innate wisdom already placed in the very core of our being. Imagine a child's first encounter with a language, or their rapid grasp of basic math like addition or subtraction. Innatism suggests that these milestones are simply not learned, but are expressions of an inner knowledge being exposed to light. This perspective on learning suggests a more uncommon approach, emphasizing a model that finds the inherent potential within each individual instead of simply acquiring new knowledge. Education, under the lens of innatism, is not about the external finding of knowledge, but the careful cultivation of the mind's fertile ground, allowing the seeds of innate wisdom to grow. In other terms, finding the right environment and supplies, much like you would choosing the right amount of sunlight, water, and the correct soil for a seed. The concept of right and wrong, often thought to be learned from societal norms, might have its roots in innate moral intuitions. This innate sense of justice and fairness challenges us to consider the origin of our ethical beliefs and how they shape our interactions and societal structures. Let's, for a moment, just say that certain truths are indeed innate. That in that case, this would reveal a fascinating tapestry of universal knowledge shared across cultures and eras, signifying a shared human heritage, a collective set of wisdom that transcends individual experiences and unites us in our quest for understanding. When we dwell deeper into the theory of innate knowledge, we begin discovering many intriguing questions and implications. If we accept that some knowledge is indeed innate, then how does this influence our understanding of creativity and new inventions? To answer that question, some might say that the creative process is merely the recombination and application of innate ideas in new, undiscovered, and novel ways. Furthermore, innatism poses compelling considerations for understanding consciousness and the self. If we're born with certain knowledge, does this suggest a shared universal consciousness or a collective unconscious, as Carl Jung would propose, where archetypes and collective wisdom reside within us all? What leads to an individual going down one path instead of another? In that case, would we all have the same chances of succeeding in life as long as we find that buried knowledge within us? It proposes a provoking thought on what is it that makes us unique if we're all born with a universal consciousness. Or maybe, we're all born with a non-collective consciousness, each with a unique and different set of knowledge. When you grasp a complex concept with ease or feel an unexplained connection to a piece of music, could this be innatism at work revealing your inherent knowledge? And what about the phenomena of genius or the prodigious talents observed in individuals like Mozart in music or Remenjian in mathematics? Innatism might offer a lens through which we view these extraordinary capabilities not merely as products of practice and environment, but as the manifestation of deeply ingrained innate abilities. As we go further into the field of innatism, perhaps we should begin wondering to ourselves, how often have we just known something to be true without understanding how we came to that knowledge? And how do our innate intuitions guide our decisions, our moral judgments, and our creative expressions? Now, while we do not have any true proof of innate knowledge, there are some arguments for it coming from the position of there needing to be an explanation for everything. I mean, we can't just magically apprehend information as a child at light speed. In the view of innatism, the information that we acquire once born has already been put into us before birth. The theory of innate knowledge compels us to wonder, not just about the world around us, but the inherent wisdom within us. You could say that innatism redefines our approach to learning and understanding. But honestly, it's much more than that. It reshapes our perception of ourselves and our connection to the universal tapestry of knowledge.